Hello everyone, welcome back to this series called Finance Current Affairs, where we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to the first question, if you haven't subscribed, then please do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you can be notified about all our upcoming videos. If you are looking forward to the free PDFs of these sessions, then you can join our Telegram group. The link is in the description below. Moving on to the first question then. It says, which of the following correctly relates to the RBI working group recommendations on digital lending? So RBI constituted a working group in the month of January, and they are asking about the correct recommendations related to digital lending, which this very committee has given, or this very working group has given, and it aims at the customer protection concerns arising out of the digital lending activities. So RBI ने एक working group बनाया था digital lending landscape को और better करने के लिए, to improve on the business conduct related to the digital lending, to ensure better customer protection, because there are a lot of concerns going on with digital lending. So recently the recommendations of that committee have come up. The report of that committee has been released. So let's discuss a bit about those recommendations. Then we'll come back to our question. First of all, talking about digital lending. Now we might need funding for various purposes. We can directly approach the banks or the financial institutions, or we can use the digital platforms as well. Digital lending is basically the automated remote lending, when we are making use of the digital technology for acquiring the customer, for doing the credit assessment, for approving the loans, for dispersing the loans, for recovering them. When all these things are carried out using the digital technology, using the automated lending process, that is digital lending. So automated lending, jab hum karte hain, sara jo process hai, wo online hota hai, ya fir technology ka use karke hota hai, digitally hota hai, that is digital lending. Okay, moving ahead now to this very working group. So RBI constituted this working group in January, okay, and why it was formulated? In order to deal with the concerns associated with digital lending. Recently on RBI website, the report of this committee has come up and the public comments are invited. So this committee came up with certain recommendations. Now based on the comments, the final decision will be taken later on. All right. So let's discuss why this committee has released this report, has come up with these recommendations. Why was there a need for all these recommendations? See, if I talk about digital lending, there are around 1100 lending apps which are there, out of which 600 proved to be illegal. This is the data as provided through the research by the working group. So the working group has carried out a research, and what it has shown that around 600 out of 1100 apps are illegal in nature. Also, there is a lot of harassment of the customers through these digital lending apps. Many of these apps are unauthorized. Okay, so in order to enhance the customer protection, to make the entire digital lending ecosystem more safe, more sound, this is the reason why this working group is working on certain recommendations to improve the digital lending sector. Okay, moving ahead now to the recommendations. Is working group ne kya kya recommendations di hai? Alag alag recommendations di hai, kuch financial protect, kuch customer ki protection se related hai, kuch technology related hai, kuch legal or regulatory framework related hai. So let's first discuss the legal and regulatory recommendations released by this working group. Some are near term and some are medium term recommendations. So first, talking about some near term recommendations. First is that a nodal agency should be set up, which will deal with the verification of the credentials of digital lending apps. So digital lending apps ki jo bhi technological credentials ki verification karni hai, uske liye ek alag se nodal agency banni chahiye. And this nodal agency will also maintain a public register of the verified apps on its website. So which apps are verified to do the digital lending, that information will be provided through the website of this nodal agency. Okay, so this agency will do the verification related to digital lending apps of balance sheet lenders and the lender service providers. So alag alag balance sheet providers, lending service providers, different the balance sheet lenders and lending service providers are providing these services to the digital lending apps. Okay, so what's this balance sheet lending, and who are these lending service providers? Balance sheet lending is when you as an institution or you as a lender is directly lending the loans and you are showing those loans you in your balance sheet. You are bearing the risks, the credit risk associated with those loans. So, jab aap apni balance sheet mein dikha rahe ho ki aap khud wo loans de rahe ho, that is balance sheet lending. And lending service, so the person who is engaging in this is balance sheet lender. And lending service providers are the agents of these balance sheet lenders who carry out some of their functions like customer acquisition, underwriting support, pricing support, disbursement, servicing, monitoring, collection. So, ye sab kaam as an agent of balance sheet lender, kaun karta hai? Lending service providers. Next recommendation is that balance sheet lending through the DLAs, that is a digital lending app, should be restricted to entities regulated and authorized by RBI. So, wohi digital lending apps balance sheet lending offer kar sakte hain jo RBI se jinko authorization mila hua hai aur RBI unhe regulate kar raha hai. Next is a self-regulatory organization will be constituted covering the participants in the digital lending ecosystem. So, digital lending related ek self-regulatory organization bani chahiye. What is a self-regulatory organization? Or an SRO. An SRO is a non-government organization. What is it? It's a non-government organization which sets, enforces rules and standards relating to the conduct of certain industry to promote the customer, protect the customer, promote the ethics, equality and professionalism. So when non-government entity is set up, which provides certain rules, regulations to improve the working of certain industry, to promote the better ethics, equality, to protect the customers, that's a self-regulatory organization. So, a non-government organization set ki jati hai jo us very industry ko aur uski working aur improve karne ki taraf work karti hai. Code of conduct provide karati hai, rules regulations provide karati hai, ethics promote karti hai, customer protection promote karti hai. All loan servicing repayments should be executed directly in the bank account of balance sheet lender and disbursements to their account of the borrower. So, agar kuch bhi amount borrower ke end se lender ko repay hona hai ya lender ke end se borrower ko milna hai, wo directly bank account transfers honge. Ye nahi ki koi kahin pe jaake cash mil raha hai, bank account transfers honge. Then, to moving on to the medium term recommendations. So, central government may consider bringing a legislation to prevent illegal lending. Illegal lending ko prevent karne ke liye ek alag se legislation banane ki baat ki ja rahi hai, called Banning of Unregulated Lending Activities Act. Then RBI should develop a separate framework, Agency Financial Service Regulation, for all customer facing fully outsourced activities of regulated entities. So sari REs ko regulate karne ke liye ek alag se framework banna chahiye jo sari customer facing fully outsourced activities ke sath deal karega. Now moving on to the technology related recommendations. Technology improve hogi tabhi digital lending aur better banegi. So usse related kya recommendations hain? First is complying with the prescribed baseline technology standards to offer digital lending. So whichever lender has to offer digital lending app, there are certain basic technology standards which they have to adhere to. Jo bhi basics technology related standards honge wo unko follow karne honge. Each digital lending app should have publicly available policies regarding data storage, usage, privacy. So, jo bhi policy related to data storage or privacy follow kar rahe hain digital lending apps, unhe wo publicly available bhi karani hai. And data should be stored in the servers located in India. Then, an adaptive comprehensive regulatory framework should be there for fintechs and techfins. So, jo bhi fintech firms hain, techfins hain, unke liye ek अलग से रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क बनाया जाए. सी फाइनेंशियल टेक्नोलॉजी बेसिकली फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज रेंडर करने के लिए टेक्नोलॉजी का यूज करने वाली फर्म्स आर दी फिनटेक्स. ओके, द फर्म्स यूजिंग टेक्नोलॉजी टू प्रोवाइड दी फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज. सो व्हाट्स द बेसिक डिफरेंस एज अपोज्ड टू फिनटेक वेयर ट्रेडिशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज आर रेंडर्ड बाय टेक्नोलॉजी. सो फिनटेक रेंडर्स फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज थ्रू टेक्नोलॉजी. Tech firm is where an entity has been delivering technology solutions, launches new way to deliver financial services. So, Techfin ek aisi entity hai jo already technology related solutions offer kar rahi thi aur ab wo naya way launch karti hai financial services deliver karne ka technology ka use karke. So, in other words, FinTech takes original financial system and improve its technology. Techfin is to rebuild the system with the technology. Moving ahead now to the recommendations related to financial consumer protection. So, consumer protection related recommendations kya hai? First, each lender should provide a key fact sheet in a standardized format. So her lender ko ek key fact sheet provide karni hai. What's a key fact sheet? It's basically a standardized form which provides the data about the fees, the charges, other credit information which can help the consumer take an informed decision. Okay. So a customer ek informed decision le sake, jo consumer hai usse related ek form milta hai jisme fees, charges, sari credit information mentioned hogi. Use of unsolicited commercial communications for digital loans should be governed by proper code of conduct. So unsolicited commercial communication ke saath deal karne ke liye proper code of conduct formulate karna chahiye. Then anti-predatory lending policies should be framed by each lender. So ek har lender ko ek anti-predatory lending policy banani chahiye. Anti-predatory lending is which is against the predatory lending. So what's predatory lending? When there are some unscrupulous practices being carried out by the lenders to entice, induce, mislead the borrowers to borrow which otherwise they can't repay or pay at higher cost. So you are basically misleading the borrowers. They might not be able to repay the loans, but you are enticing them, inducing them to borrow from you, and later you try to recover more higher cost from them. Okay, so you are taking the advantage of the borrowers because they are ignorant because of certain circumstances. So आप उनको mislead करके जब loans provide करते हो, उनकी situation का फायदा उठाते हो, वो ignorant है इस चीज का फायदा उठाते हो, that kind of lending is predatory lending. So anti-predatory policy बनानी है हर lender को और वो follow करनी होगी. Moving ahead now, now moving back to our question, we had to identify the correct recommendations. So a nodal agency should be set up for technological credential verification, yes. Self-regulatory organization should be set up, yes. All loan servicing, repayment, disbursement should be made providing cash to the lenders and borrowers through cash vault set up with certain registered banks and NBFC. Koi cash vault bana ke cash nahi pay hoga, directly bank account transfers. Bank mein seedha paisa jayega, bank account mein. So this is incorrect. First two are correct, answer is option C. Moving to the second question. Digital lending is driven by a combination of supply and demand side factors. Identify the supply side factors contributed to rise in digital lending. So see, digital lending ki agar main baat karu, if I talk about digital lending, it has grown in India a lot. India comprises of most number of digital lending apps in the world. Okay, we are moving towards a digital economy, economy less dependent on cash, on circulation of cash, and now going more towards digital platforms. Okay, so there are certain demand and certain supply side factors that are contributing to the same. Kuch demand side factors hai, kuch supply side factors hai, jo overall hamari digital lending ki growth promote kar rahe hain. So let's discuss these factors. If I talk about the factors or the supply side drivers, they include all those factors which increase the supply of the digital lending apps, enhance its quality, enhance its availability. So jo factors digital lending apps ki availability badhate hain, wo hote hain supply side factors, like technological advancements. If there will be improvement in the technology, it will become more easier to come up with digital lending platforms and for the people to utilize them. So various technological advancements like the mobile internet, alternative data, artificial intelligence, cloud computing and many more technologies, they all are the supply side driver. Then the government initiatives. Government agar koi initiative le rahi hai digital lending ko promote karne ka, boost karne ka, to obviously wo digital lending promote karega. Agar government keh rahi hai ki hum digitally hi lend karenge, so obviously digital lending platforms promote honge. Okay, if the government is saying that we'll be lending digitally only, then obviously these platforms will be promoted. So Jan Dhan Yojana, Digital India, Startup Ecosystem and different initiatives of the government give a boost to digital lending. Then is regulatory enablers. Various regulatory frameworks are there which give a boost to digital lending, like RBI's regulatory sandbox, innovation hub. So these promote the innovations. Using technology, you can better render the financial services. There are app-based NBFCs and there are various other initiatives. Then is internet and mobile penetration. Agar logo ke paas easily mobile phones available hai, smartphones available hai, internet facility available hai, internet connections, wifi connections available hai, to wo easily digital lending ka use karenge. So ye sare supply side factors hai. Okay, availability of internet, smartphones, having internet subscriptions, broadband subscriptions, mobile connections, all these make it easier to use the digital platform. So all of them are supply side drivers. Now talking about the demand side drivers. अगर डिमांड होगी डिजिटल लेंडिंग एप्स की तभी तो सप्लाई आएगा. सो डिमांड साइड इफ देयर इज डिमांड ऑफ डिजिटल लेंडिंग एप्स देन ओनली द सप्लाई विल कम. सो व्हाट आर द डिमांड साइड ड्राइवर्स which when boost the demand of digital lending app will increase the overall growth of digital lending. So first is demographics. If we have more young population who are using digital platforms, they will demand the digital lending apps and it will give boost to digital lending. Then is economic development. If people's income is growing, if there is increase in per capita GDP, so all that will contribute to improvement in overall digital system. The people will start demanding these things more, they will become more educated, and it will give a boost to digital lending. Then is unmet demand. Now, people want the money, but traditional banks are not able to offer that money, especially to the small borrowers. So they will rely on the digital lending apps. Right, so it will again give boost to digital lending. And then is COVID-19 pandemic. During pandemic, we have seen that people needed money, there was financial stress, social distancing, people lost their employment, their wages. So this also gave boost to relying on the digital lending apps, on the digital lending platforms to raise that funding. So these are the demand side factors. Coming back to our question and identifying supply side factors. So technological advancement, regulatory enablers, internet and mobile penetration are supply side factor. Digital natives and higher proportion of young population is a demand side factor. So first three, answer is option C. Moving to the next question now. Identify the statements incorrectly related to cryptocurrency. So recently we are seeing a lot of news going on related to cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency ki bahut baat chal rahi hai ki ye ban ho jayegi ya abhi bhi hum isme invest kar payenge. So there's a lot of confusion regarding whether it's going to be banned or not. Okay, so let's go through the thing that what's going on related to cryptocurrency. First of all, what's RBI's stance on cryptocurrency? See, RBI has not recognized cryptocurrency as legal tender. Cryptocurrency legal tender nahi hai. In fact, banks were prohibited from processing the transactions related to cryptocurrencies in 2018. But then in 2020, SEBI invalidated this ban. Okay, so in 2018, mein ek ban laga tha ki banks jo hai, wo transactions process nahi karenge cryptocurrency se related. But 2020 mein ye ban hat gaya tha. So RBI is although not in the favor of cryptocurrencies, but it has not yet been banned. Okay, it is not yet legal tender and RBI is working on coming up with central bank digital currency. It has not yet come up. Okay, it is working on it. And there are various macroeconomic financial stability concerns related to cryptocurrency. So let's discuss few concerns. One is that if people will start investing their savings in cryptocurrency, it will reduce the demand of the fixed deposits and all. So less money going with the banks, less money available to lend. क्रिप्टोकरेंसी में आपकी सारी सेविंग इन्वेस्ट हो जाएगी तो आप बैंक्स में वो पैसा नहीं रखोगे, बैंक्स में नहीं रखोगे तो बैंक्स के पास पैसा नहीं होगा, वो लेंड कैसे करेंगे. सो होल प्रोसेस विल बी अफेक्टेड. ओके, बट द मेजर कंसर्न एसोसिएटेड विद क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इज दैट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू ट्रेस द क्रिप्टो. इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू ट्रेस इट देन इट विल बिकम डिफिकल्ट टू टैक्स इट. इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू ट्रेस इट इट विल बिकम मोर प्रोन टू क्रिमिनल एक्टिविटी, टू मनी लॉन्डरिंग. Then cryptocurrencies, everything is digital, so there are chances of hacking, scams, and also there is a lot of volatility. So these are some concerns associated with cryptocurrency. Inko aap track nahi kar sakte, kyunki track nahi kar sakte, tax karne mein problem aayegi, money laundering ho sakti hai, criminal activities ho sakti hai, hacking ke chances hai, scam ke chances hai, volatility bahut hai. Aaj janak se value itni upar pahunch jati hai, kal ekdam se niche aa jati hai, ek tweet se value niche chali jati hai, upar aa jati hai. So a lot of volatility is there. You might earn a lot through this, but you might also lose a lot of amount through this. Okay. Moreover, it's not a reliable source because it's not regulated. It's very important that it gets regulated. So recent stance, if I talk about recent stance, see in February, a cryptocurrency bill was formulated. It was proposed, but it was not introduced into parliament. Okay. Recently in an address, our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi has also expressed the concerns related to these cryptocurrencies. He has warned that Bitcoin presents a lot of risk to the young generation and their government is preparing to come up with some legislation to regulate the digital currencies. Okay, there are high chances of money laundering and terror financing associated with this digital currency, the cryptocurrency thing. So there's a need to work on that area. Also, the government is introducing the cryptocurrency regulation of and regulation of official digital currency bill in this very year's parliamentary session. So ab jo parliamentary session hoga usme propose kara usme ye bill propose kiya jayega, which is going to prohibit all private currencies. Okay, so let's see whether there will be a ban imposed on cryptocurrency or not. People, when they heard about this thing that this bill will be presented and cryptocurrencies will be banned, they started panic selling. Okay, they dumped on their securities which they had, or dumped on the cryptocurrencies which they had, and we saw a major fall. But then the information came that it might happen that the government does not altogether ban them, but in the government might considering allowing cryptocurrency trading for some investors. Okay, it might bring it under the oversight of local regulators. So abhi ye nahi kaha ja sakta ki completely ban kar diya jayega. Ho sakta hai usko better way mein regulate kar diya jaye, ya kuch type ke investors ko allow kiya jaye. So let's see what decision is taken. Okay, as of now it's not a legal tender, but it has not yet been banned. Okay, so coming back to the question and identifying the incorrect statement. First says RBI has banned cryptocurrency and introduced central bank digital currency. No, not yet. Second says cryptocurrency's concern is the criminal activity, money laundering. Yes. Cryptocurrency is vulnerable to hacking and scams and all. Yes. So first is incorrect. Answer is option A. Now coming to the last question of the day. RBI has imposed a monetary penalty on which of the following authorized payment operators recently? So recently RBI has notified that on two payment operators it has imposed a monetary penalty. So those two operators are Tata Communications Payment Solution Limited and Appnet Technologies Private Limited. So answer is option B. Both of these payment operators, they have not adhered to certain provisions because of which this penalty has been imposed. It's around 200 lakhs for your TCPSL and for ATPL it's 54.93 lakhs. They have not adhered to white label ATM deployment targets, net worth requirement, escrow account balance. They are not able to maintain that, and they have not adhered to certain provisions of your Payments and Settlement Systems Act. So two terms are worth noting over here: white label ATM and escrow account. Okay, so if I talk about white label ATMs, they are the ATMs owned operated by non-bank entities. So bank ke nahi balki non-bank ke ATMs hote hain wo. SBI ka ya ICICI ka ATM na hoke kisi non-bank entity ka ATM hai, jaise ki Tata ke ATMs hai, IndiCash ATMs. Okay, then talking about escrow. Escrow is basically using the third party which holds the assets or funds before they are transferred from one party to the another. So if two parties are dealing, okay, there will be a third party who will hold the funds on their behalf. Okay, so because there might be certain conditions which are yet to be fulfilled. So once they are fulfilled, then the transaction will be processed. So this third party holds the assets before they are transferred from one party to the other. Third party holds the funds until both parties have fulfilled their contractual agreement. अब इन दोनों के बीच कोई contractual agreement है, जब दोनों ने वो conditions पूरी नहीं की है, तब तक पैसा किसी third party के पास रुका रहेगा. That third party is escrow. An escrow arrangement safeguards the seller against risk of payment default by buyer, as it removes the control of cash from the buyer to an independent party. The holder of the escrow account makes sure that the amount is released on fulfillment of specific conditions. So escrow account में वो पैसा held रहता है, फिर जब वो conditions fulfill हो जाती है तब वो process होता है. So this was all for today's session. I hope it was useful for you. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.